Aditi Nirukar joins us now to talk a little bit more about this pandemic today. And Doc, I want to start with actually staying on COVID and pregnancy while we're talking about that. There are a lot of pregnant women like Stephanie, we just heard about in that story, who have major concerns related to the health of their baby and the vaccine. So as a doctor, what would you say to women who are pregnant and hesitant at this point?
You know, Aaron, I'm a doctor and I'm also a mother. So this is an issue that is really near and dear to my heart. I really feel for all of the pregnant women who do not want to get vaccinated, but vaccination is the safest bet for a healthy mom and a healthy baby. We know that only 23% of pregnant women are vaccinated, and vaccination protects tremendously, not just for the mother. We know pregnant women have a higher need for the ICU, ventilators, and oxygen, as well as hospitalization when they get COVID. But a new study from the University of California shows that there is a 40% risk of premature labor and premature delivery with pregnancy and COVID. So all the more reason to get vaccinated. I understand the hesitation, but the vaccines are entirely safe in pregnancy. CDC and ACOG have both put out statements, albeit a little too late, but the statements are there encouraging women who are pregnant to get vaccinated.
So let's talk a little bit about kids now. The American Academy of Pediatrics says that one third of COVID cases since September 9th have been in children. Talk to us a little bit, if you can, about how the Delta variant is impacting the symptoms and the severity of some of the cases that we're seeing in kids.
You know, Aaron, it's unclear right now whether it is the Delta variant or whether it is simply the larger number of adults around the children that are causing the rise in cases. We know that right now about 15% of all cases of COVID are pediatric, and there's been an exponential rise. In the 2 weeks alone, we've had 500,000 cases of COVID alone in children. So this is a very concerning finding. We are teasing out why this is occurring. But most importantly, if we want to protect our children, we must protect the adults around them by getting vaccinated. That is always the message.
All right, Dr. Aditi Nirukar, we appreciate your time today. Thank you.